one more question, sir. Like, you know, there are different types of counselors are there, sir. What is specifically marriage counseling different? How is it different from the other, you know, mentors or psychologists or psychiatrists? How is that, sir? And one more thing along this I want to ask is, are people open to come and talk to you openly, or still there is a cliche, or still there is a stigma attached to, so why should we be vulnerable? We can keep quiet. Why should we open up? Usually it's there, no, sir. People don't go to psychologists and psychiatrists for that reason. Is that the same with you, sir? And how do you face, when you face such kind of couple where you don't open up too much, but still they say a little bit of their information? How do you see, sir?
See, one thing you asked me, you asked me two questions.
Yes.
One is, how it is different. Mine is a mathematically measurable, result-oriented mentoring. Okay, I go beyond counseling. There is a difference between counseling, coaching, and mentoring. Teaching is only teaching. They give the knowledge. Counseling is taking the person who is drowning to the shore.
Oh.
If he is drowned, that is counseling. And a person who is on the shore, make him run, is coaching. Okay. So the whole thing is called mentoring. Mentoring is more than counseling. What I do, I told you, not take a seed, put them, nurture them, make them into a base they handle. That is the reason 3 months, why these couples are there with me for 3 months. Every day they have to set goals. And I'm different between mentor and a teacher. The mentor is accountable. Next day I have to account why you cannot produce a result. I'm doing skills. I'm teaching them doing skills, not knowing skills. Teachers need only knowing. Knowing is not equal to doing. And I apply a technique called NLP, Neuro-Linguistic Programming. I started in India. The Neuro-Linguistic Programming is a mathematical psychology. Results has to come. If results are not coming, there are only two mistakes. I am not guiding you properly, or you are not doing it. That is the reason. And moreover, our school of psychology is positive psychology. If you go to a psychologist, you go with any problem, he will tell you, go for the find the root cause. Okay. They assume that there is a problem at the end of the psychological problem. There is specific reason. Either he is under depression, or he's having guilt feeling, or he's having a phobia. They move with that assumption. But ours is not like that. We don't believe in that there is a past. Because what happens in the past, you do a lot of research, a lot of tests. The test will pile up. But the patient will die. That is the reason the NLP is a different school of psychology, where we take him to positive. Irrespective of the background, I want you to see the future. The energy you spend in the back end, we spent in the front end. Forget it, whether you're good, bad, ugly, forget about it. What actually happened, if you look at that, see, I want to forget that, isn't it? But you are making me to think about it. Therefore, you are going to further depression. That is where we don't take people there. We want result. Now we produce results. Number one. What was the second question?
I was asking that, why is that? Sir, I forgot. What did I ask?
One question was this one.
I just checked the question 1 minute, sir. Yeah. So I was just asking about, you know, why is that, you know, today's generation, when there is an issue, when they really want to split, you mentor them to stay back? Or
That is right. I'm not here a person to recommend divorce or go against divorce. There are genuine reasons where they badly need divorce. Okay, and moreover, what actually happens is this is from the clinical lab. No, when the client comes to me, maybe one or two sessions, they may reluctantly come, maybe for the husband's sake or wife's sake. But the third session, fourth session, once they feel I am very, very sincere in their approach, they tell the whole truth. Okay, so this is the story, that is not the story. That I have to tell because my father-in-law is in the picture. That I have to make father in the picture. My husband in the picture. This is what, sometimes when they tell the truth, I don't have any answer. So the lady has taken a very powerful decision. That is a decision. Nobody can take a better decision than what she is doing at that time. So I don't have an answer. I only say, what should I do? Shall I tell you? No, I don't want to sell. Don't want to tell. I can only relieve your stress. If you are not allowing me to talk to them, then I cannot do that. But I am not a person to go for mentoring or not. See, I case, there was a case where a lady wanted to go for a fourth time for a remarriage. That they were doing the pre-marriage. I have got a pre-marriage lab. A pre-marriage lab is where we take the lady and with her husband's data and make him experience the future family. 10 days, he has to experience the future family, how he has to tackle the father, how the father-in-law, mother-in-law. Then when I did the compatibility, I told, your first husband is better than what you're thinking. I told her, sir, how do you know that? No, the data you gave, I gave it. Yes, sir, I want to go back, but he's already settled. I cannot go back. I can go as a friend, but I cannot go into life. And you are doing the same mistake. The why you reject your first husband, second husband is because of these mistakes.
Wow.
Okay, not because you are getting a better partner. Never you will get a better partner. Auntie, unless you are doing repeating the same mistake, you're assuming a partner will come. And afterwards, he becomes sorry, go for that. Then afterwards, she didn't believe for some period. Afterwards, the first husband came, then this person came. Then afterwards, she was convinced. Because what actually these people are doing is, without realizing their mistake, they think if I get a better partner, I'll be settled better.
Oh.
That is where I made her realize. And of course, she has withdrawn the distance, that decision. So we are not here to say good or bad, ugly. That is their life. Because ultimately, once they take the responsibility, they have to face that. There are cases where even after now, I am doing a couple who are drivers, but they say, sir, I want you to counsel us so that we do not know why we are doing mistakes. Because now I have to, the son is with me and the daughter is with her. I have to take care, sir. I have to take a tip from my wife. So we want her, let she have her own life. I will have mine. But for the sake of children, you counsel us. You kindly tell us what are the mistakes we are doing. There are couples like that also. And second thing, you told people are coming. Yes, they are coming. Because now, because of IT sector, what happens, a lot of people are going to Western coming up. They're going back to America and coming back is not a problem. They know about it. But I have two clinics. One clinic is in OMR. It is in IT sector here in Chennai. And Thamaram. Thamar is a typical traditional parents, first generation parents.
Okay.
What I say, I tell, sir, my son is doing very well. You are helping him out. And why don't you do one more counseling for another 4 or 5 sessions? I told, I can do that, but provided you help me, what help you want? I want you to come for counseling.
No.
Then the parent, that OMR parent, the IT parent, they are ready. But traditional parents are there. Sir, what, sir, at this age, what you are teaching is not required. I'll give money. You teach to my son. Your son is very intelligent. I cannot question him beyond a particular point. Please understand. Android generation is very, very intelligent. They go to internet, they do all the homework, then they come back. So don't, I tell them, it is not easy to fool your son. He may not be talking with you, but he talks with everybody. Either you update or you face the truth. Don't think your son is ordinary. Early in the morning, same innocent face. Evening, same innocent. In between innocent, a lot of information has gone. One MBBS syllabus is going every day in a child's mind. Parents are getting outdated. They are not worried about that. Then children will be always like that. And the same thing, if you don't improve, one more, I tell the same thing. If you don't improve, what's going to happen? The same modeling. Mm-hmm. And I tell him, in other words, see, do you want your grandson to come and getting counseled with my grandson? That is what you're exporting. The same behavior from father, you imported it. Now you don't want to alter that for software. You're passed on to next generation, third generation.
Got it.
So naturally, you'll be like that only.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.